Well, we want to take the time we have left in this program to answer some of your email questions. Pat, this first one is from Eva, who says, Pat, I usually dress casually when I go to church, but it's nothing inappropriate. The problem is people are always giving me a hard time about what I wear. Does God care how we dress for church? Can't I just come as I am?
Well, Eva, let me tell you, if you were going to have an audience with the Queen of England, would you show up at Buckingham Palace with a halter top and a cut-off jeans and flip-flops?
Yeah.
The answer is no way. You dress up, boy, you're going to meet with the Queen. Same thing if you go into the White House, you're going to meet with the President. You wouldn't go in sort of casual, but yet we think we can go before God with just all this slovenly stuff. I see these kids, I mean, it's just disgusting. I don't think God is all hung up on clothes, but I do think it's important to show respect. You're in the house of the Lord, and there needs to be a certain amount of reverence. We're in God's house. Mm-hmm. And in the old days, he dealt very harshly with those who took advantage of it. But your question is, does God care whether you're all dressed up or not? And the answer is absolutely not, because the worst thing you could do is to spend all your time flossing yourself up all pretty. Mm-hmm. And so you want people to look at you instead of the Lord. You want to, the Bible says, let the women be dressed modestly. All right.
This is Corrine, who says, Pat, I've been living with my boyfriend for years now, and we're still not married. He doesn't want to marry me because of his previous bad marriage. There's a part of me that still desires marriage. What can I do?
Walk out. The sooner the better. You're doing something that's wrong, and he's playing you for a fool. He's had a, quote, previous bad marriage. Well, tough luck. I mean, you can't do that. The trouble with women, they don't realize that men are interested in having physical relations. And if they give them the physical relations with no obligation, then they'll take them gladly. And then they'll walk out on them when there's any obligation put upon them. You know, it's a partnership. And if a man doesn't want to marry you, then don't live with him. All right?
This is Luz, who says, I've made 20 years of mistakes and bad choices, even though I went to church. I slept around with different men and hurt people that were close to me. I feel like it's too late for God to help me. Is there still hope for me after so many years of poor judgment?
Luz, there's always hope. There's always hope in God. He loves you, and he wants to forgive you. And what he's concerned about is that you would be cleansed from dead works to serve the living God. That's what the Bible says. Get all that stuff behind you, and the minute you come to the Lord, he'll take care of it. You don't, the past, you leave it behind. What else?
Well, this next one's a long one, so I don't think we have time
try.
For it. Well, okay. My parents divorced 10 years ago. My dad stole $4,000 from me several years ago, so I haven't talked with him in 2 years. Basically, his relationship with family is non-existent. I plan to talk with him soon because I think he's giving up on life.
I think you've got to go to him, tell him you want him as a father, you need a father, and you honor him as a father. And even though he's done terrible things, you tell him you forgive him and you love him, and you love him unconditionally, but that you want to be a father, you want him to be your father, and you want to be his son, and tell him you love him. And if he doesn't respond to it, just keep praying for him. But that will soften his heart, and that's all you can do. And I don't think I'd do anything else. A confrontation is not the answer. We leave you today with these words from Hebrews 13:5. Be content with what you have, because God has said, never will I leave you, never will I forsake you. Well, that's all the time we've got. Have a great weekend, and we'll be talking to you again on Mondays. Until then, goodbye.